Today, let's discuss how to analyze the return on investment in long-term investments. Hi, this is Mike Negami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. We are experts in process improvement. We prioritize the issues and problems and make and conduct Kaizen projects. For that prioritizing, it's very effective to analyze the return on investment for each project. You can use this method for real estate investment, IT investment, and so on in the same way. You want to see how much money you'd spend on and how much profit return you'd receive from each project. We can use ROI for that, which stands for return on investment. The calculation formula is simpler. It's a percentage of the profit amount obtained from the project divided by the amount you spend on the project. For example, if you earn $20,000 on a project and you spend $100,000 on, that will be $20,000 divided by $100,000. So the return on investment will be 20%. Projects with a higher percentage of return on investment will have higher priority. That formula itself is easy, but it's quite difficult to use it in practice. No one can predict the future. Some people say, even if you calculate such a thing, it's never accurate. It may be true, but I strongly recommend doing this. In order to complete the calculation, you have to compare the way you've been doing things so far and the way you'd do in the future. In some cases, you even have to consider the wages of your employees. I made an Excel template for an investment analysis, and I'll show you how to do that analysis accordingly. With this template, you can compare up to 5 projects or investment cases. First, write each project name here. The investment period is the period of the investment effectiveness. It's a maximum of 10 years in this template. In addition to the return on investment percentage, you can get the payout time, which is how many years later the investment will be paid back. Of course, the shorter that number, the better the investment is. Here is one problem. If there is a project with a higher return on investment percentage and a short payout time, is it the best investment? It's not so. It may just be a small investment project. You can see how much profit that amount can actually be expected in that next measurement, net present value, in short, NPV. Let me ask you, if you can choose whether somebody give you $10,000 today or will give you $10,000 one year later, which is better? Of course, you want it today before they change their mind. There is another reason. The current $10,000 value is worth more than $10,000 a year later, because you can get interest just by putting some money in savings account. Since the investment is for several years, it's necessary to consider that the net value decrease over time. This net present value shows the total of the expense and profit amounts within the investment period after converting them into the current period value, depending on their years. If this amount is negative, it means that investment has failed. The larger the amount, the better the investment. Please check the Excel formula in the cells for the net present value calculation. Put a percentage for how much value will decrease manually in the next column, depreciate rate. You can change the percentage for each project. By the way, in this template, both the return on investment and payout time are calculated from their net present value, which better reflects reality. Please examine each investment project at various angles according to the return on investment, payout time, and net present value, and prioritize your project. The net present value is the most important, but please be aware that this number will change considerably depending on the investment period and depreciation rate. These three calculations are done automatically by Excel, but the difficult thing is to enter estimated investment dollar amount and profit dollar amount from each project, which will be the source data of the calculation. Think of each project and enter all their investments as negative numbers in the cash out sections in the light blue cells and their gross profits in positive numbers in the cash in sections. Clicking the plus icon here opens the hidden columns and allows you to enter for 10 years entries. Project A is the investment in manufacturing machinery as an example. Put the purchase amount as a negative number in the current column. Then, if there are maintenance costs and or administrative expenses afterwards, put in those dollar amounts every year. If you hired new people due to the new machines, put those labor costs in the cash out section as well. Next, let's think about profit, which is cash in. If there is a profit on sales of the old machines due to setting new machines, add that amount as a positive number. Since maintenance costs of the old machines were ended, add them as positive numbers. If the new machine's maintenance costs are lower than the old ones, it would be profitable. As other cash in, if you can expect new sales because of introducing the new machines, add their gross margin amount from the sales. If you'd have sales losses, if you hadn't purchased the new machines, you should put their gross margins in cash in too. Sometimes you have to be creative. For example, such as when you are evaluating quality improvement results or calculating time savings. You need to convert those results into monetary value by considering sales increased due to the quality improvement or by calculating from labor cost. This evaluation is totally depending on the situation and there's no right answer. However, because of discussions and these investment analyses among stakeholders, they will gain a deep understanding of all investment projects. Therefore, this will be a very valuable activity. You'll use this as judgment material for the investment projects, but do not end with that. Since you'd have forecasts for several years, you can use them for your PDCA cycle every year afterwards. When more detailed data comes out as you go, you may adjust your forecast and use them as lessons learned to improve your next investment analysis. Thank you very much for viewing. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.